In this video, we're going to talk about a method for how to solve systems of equations using something called a substitution method. So basically it works something like this. So you've got all your equations in your system, and what we're going to do is we're going to pick one variable and solve for it in any of the equations. It doesn't matter which equation and it doesn't matter which variable, but I would recommend try to pick an easy one. Now, what do I mean by easy one? If any of your variables especially have a coefficient of 1, the algebra turns out to be really easy to solve for that guy because you don't have any coefficient to divide out at the end. So, you know, if you had like a 4y at some point to solve for y, you'd have to divide by 4 and get a bunch of fractions. So if any of your variables have a coefficient of 1, go for that one. But other than that, it really doesn't even matter which variable you solve for, and it doesn't matter which equation you use. But in any case, once you solve for that guy, you're going to take him and you're going to substitute him into the other equation. And we're going to go through an example in just a second, if you bear with us. Okay, and then once you do that, what's going to happen is instead of having an equation with two variables with a million different solutions, you have an equation just with one variable that will just have a single solution. So once you solve that guy, you should end up with your final answer. So for example, something like this, let's say you had 3x minus 2y equals 7, and 4x plus y equals 13. Together, that makes a system of equations, and what we're trying to find is an ordered pair x, y that makes both of the equations be true. So out of the system right here, the guy I think I would solve for is probably this guy, because he has a coefficient of 1. So you could solve for y, like here you'd get negative 4x plus 13. And then what I was referencing here when I was talking about number 2 was that you're going to substitute that guy now into the other equation, the other meaning the first equation. Now, where do you substitute it? Well, notice this right here is a y just like what we solved for. So we know that y is the same as negative 4x plus 13. So why not take this y out and cut and paste negative 4x plus 13 in there? And then you'll notice in your first equation, which I won't write out all the details right now, you wouldn't have x's and y's, you just have x's, and then you could finish it out. All right, so we're going to work through two examples here. So I'll actually start with this one, and we'll finish this one out, and then we'll do another one. All right, so let's get to it. So here, let me start by doing the same thing I did earlier. We'll take this guy over here, y equals negative 4x plus 13. All right, and then this guy is going to go in for the y in the first equation. So you'd have 3x minus, what I usually do is I'll write 2y equals 7, but instead of a y, I'll just leave a giant blank. And then I'll say, okay, well, y is the same as negative 4x plus 13. This is a single equation with just one variable, just x, that we should be pretty good at solving. So let's distribute the negative 2. We'd have 3x plus 8x, because that's minus a negative, minus 26 equals 7. Combine like terms, so 11x equals, let's take 26 and add it to the right hand side, we'll get 33. Divide both sides by 11 and you'll get x equals 3. But we're not done, that's just the x. You need an ordered pair x and y. So for that, you can go back and use any old equation. It doesn't matter, all the equations are true. You can use the first, the second, or any of the orange. You know, I think I'm leaning towards, well, I guess the orange wouldn't do you much good because they don't have any y's, but in any of the first two green equations or this one in orange. And I would always recommend using the guy where you solved for y, because that should be somewhere in your previous work. You just take that equation, pop in your x is 3. So negative 4 times 3 plus 13. That'll be negative 12 plus 13, which is 1. So I think y would equal 1. So that ordered pair 3, 1 should be the solution to the system. You can check it, and I would encourage you to check it, especially for a test or something. It just takes 2 seconds. You can even do it in your head. Let's try it. 3 times 3 is 9. 9 minus 2 times 1 is 7. Hey, looks good. And 4 times 3 is 12. 12 plus 1, y is 1. 12 and 1 make 13. So it satisfied the system because it made both of the equations be true. So that's a very classic exercise right there, the one that we just did. It's very, very, very typical. All right, let's try one that's a little bit more difficult. Maybe you can tell me what's more difficult about this one. 5x minus 2y equals negative 8, and negative 3x plus 5y equals 20. Now, what's harder about that? It looks pretty similar to the last example. Well, if you notice, none of these have a coefficient of 1. That's really unfortunate. I hate that, but we can still do it. It would just be better if it had a coefficient of 1. So pick anybody, x, y, it doesn't matter. I guess I'll just pick this first guy right here. Okay, so solving for that x, we'd have 5x equals 2y minus 8. If we add 2y to the right, divide both sides by 5, you'll get 2/5 y minus 8/5. Yes, I know we have fractions. Yes, I know that's ugly. Not really much we can do about that. All right, take this for x and stick it in for x in the other equation. We'll have negative 3 times x, that's the way I like to do it, just leave a big empty blank, plus 5y equals 20. Take that expression for x and plug it in. 2/5 y minus 8/5. Distribute. Yes, we have to deal with fractions, but we can do it. Negative 6/5 y plus 24/5 plus 5y equals 20. Let's combine like terms. -6/5 and 5. Let's write this as 25/5 so that we have a common denominator. -6/5 plus 25/5, I think that would be 19/5 y equals, and then we'll take this 24/5 and subtract it to the right. So we'll do -24/5, and I'm kind of running out of space, so I'm just going to shuffle them around in the same equation here. So I'll mark it out on the left and subtract it over here to the right. And then for the 20, common denominator of 5, let's write 20 as 100 over 5. This is also 20, but that way we have a denominator of 5. 100 over 5 minus 24 over 5 would be 76 over 5. All right, almost done. We can multiply both sides by 5. That'll get rid of the 5s. All right, now come back over here. So 19y equals 76. So y would be, what's that, 4? Yeah, I believe that'd be 4. So y is 4. And then we also need the x that goes with it. Pick any old equation. It doesn't matter which one you use. Let's just try maybe this one right here. If y is 4, 2/5 times 4 is 8/5. 8/5 minus 8/5 gives us 0. So there's your ordered pair, 0 comma 4. That would be your solution. You can check it, of course. 0 minus 8 is negative 8. 0 plus 20 is 20. So yeah, that works out perfectly fine. So anyways, hopefully that helps you understand how to solve a system of equations by substitution. I would say out of all the methods that you're going to learn with me, that method right there is probably the most commonly used method. Graphing has a lot of downsides. Elimination method or addition method only works sometimes, but substitution works pretty darn near all the time. So it's a very, very popular way of solving systems. So I would encourage you to commit a lot of energy to learning this method well, because I think it'll serve you well in solving all of your different systems.